Good morning, everybody on YouTube. I am ShadowBlazer3000. This is a vlog, of course, as it says in the title, giving my post-wrap-up news of Anime Banzai, which is my local convention based out of Layton, Utah. Not my hometown, by the way, but it's just close enough that it's a convenient travel for me. But as the title suggests, like I did last year, I want to just give up my little post-thoughts about the convention overall, what I did, what I bought, and hopefully encourage your people to either go to a con nearby yourself, because they are lots of fun, or who knows, maybe one day you'll even be able to come out to our little, humble little con. Now, if you're new to my channel, if you didn't see my vlog last year, just a quick rundown. Anime Banzai is a local anime convention based in the Utah, greater Salt Lake City area, you could say. Started over 10 years ago now. As a little college-ran convention. Now it's a fully owned, I believe it's a non-profit group, or it's some kind of halfway between a corporation. I'm not sure. The con has definitely changed from its humble little college origins to what it is today. While we are still small fish, probably, compared to bigger cons like Anime Expo or Comic-Con or even Salt Lake Comic-Con, but we're still a nice, tight-knit little community that comes together to just have some fun over the weekend and express our geekdom. Now, the days leading up to the con were a little, of course, busy between having to work, but also I was a little worried because I was like, it felt like I was getting a cold. It felt like I was coming down with something. I'm like, not again. Because last year, a week before the con, I got slammed by a cold, and I was worried I was going to miss it because it just like, I felt like crap the whole time. Not the whole time through the con, thankfully, but just the days leading up. It was a week before the con. For most people, it probably wouldn't be a problem, but for me, colds and I don't get along very well, and they love to stick around, and they love to overstay their welcome. But I made it last year just in time. I felt like Yui Hirasawa the day she had to go perform on stage, and she forgot her gita and had to run back and forth to her house and get it. But she got sick before that day, and it was the race to get better. I'm rambling now. This year, though, thankfully, while I felt a little iffy the days before the con, on the day of the con, I felt just fine. I didn't go in as early as I should have, probably. I just felt like I'd better sleep in and see how I feel in the morning. But I felt great, and I made it all the way up, but parking was a bitch because I left late. Okay, so that's about enough of story time. As for what I did at the con, now, if you've never been to an anime con before, there's always lots of things to do. There's usually guests, there's merchandise to buy, there's panels to go to. Panels are always ran by people like yours truly. In fact, I did do some panels this year, and I'll get into that. And of course, the panels are always ran by fans and always about different topics, right? And it doesn't have to always be strictly anime. Of course, it can relate to manga, it can even relate to video games and lots of stuff. You know, these conventions are generally very inclusive. That's why I love them. There's, of course, an artist room where you can always see what local artists and artists from maybe around the country who might be traveling or working on, and you can buy art. It's so much fun to go. Really, if you got a chance to ever go to a con, go to a con. And you'll even notice I'm wearing some art. And I'll get into what these are in a minute. Also, I have a press pass. Boom, I'm legit! Not really. As for our guests, unfortunately, we were supposed to have Christopher Savant, but last minute he had to cancel. I'm not sure exactly why. I guess there was a scheduling conflict, perhaps, and it wasn't really his fault, I guess. It was whoever was in charge of booking him, which is not through the convention, but it was a different agency or something. I'm not really sure what happened, so unfortunately the big draw for me, guest-wise, couldn't make it out, which is so sad because I like Chris Sabat and there's lots of roles I've seen him in and would love to have had his autograph smacked on everything I could get, even though I'm pretty sure they had limited autographs. There are other guests, of course, but most of them were either very cosplay-centric, which, nothing against cosplayers, I love cosplayers, but as such, I'm not really an avid cosplayer myself, so I don't go crazy for cosplay guests. There's, of course, Steve Warkiti Chocobo Nunez, who's there every year, But he's always like the guest of honor, but he's there every year. I think the man just lives there. And there was actor Chris Kaysen, which he's definitely been in a ton of anime, and I'm sure I've seen a fair amount of them, but I can't really put a name to the face. I can't put any roles to the name either. So I didn't really go out of my way to see him either. I'm sure he's a splendid guy. I'm sure he's nice. And if you saw him, I'm sure you enjoyed him. I know he also had a panel on Sunday, which I didn't go. I left early. Now, as I mentioned, I myself got to be on a couple panels, which is the first ever. I've gone to many panels in my times at cons, but I've never actually been a panelist, which was amazing and downright terrifying. No, it was okay. I was actually pretty fine, but I think you could cut it. I'm sure if you watch the videos, you'll probably hear my voice quiver up and down a little bit, I'm sure, because I get a. It takes me a bit, but I can get a little stage fright at times. So I can. I'll grow into it usually. So, panels that I hosted, of course, one was with my podcast group, which we do geek news, reviews, and opinions. We actually had. Well, we had a live recording, which of course nobody really came, but it's a live podcast recording, and the convention wasn't very good about advertising podcast recordings. So, and there was another podcast group there too, and well, no one else really showed up there either, probably except a few loyal supporters and fans, but like I said, it was kind of an empty thing because the convention just didn't advertise the podcasting very well. I should have stuck around for the feedback panel in hindsight. But as I mentioned, we did a recording for Geek News Reviews and Opinions. We also did a panel of our own, which was sort of a how-to basics of building your own YouTube channel, making content, reviewing, abridging, which is frankly the last person is me who should be telling anybody what to do about that. That just more like just trying to give some friendly advice that we've experienced in trying to grow our own channels, even though we're small fries, so people did definitely attend that. But it was 10 o'clock at night, and what can you say? We're a small local podcast group. We're not a huge draw yet. And of course, I hosted two other panels, well, co-hosted in fairness. I'm not the big poobah here, but I co-hosted a couple other panels. One, of course, was celebrating 20 years of Pokemon, talking about everybody's favorite myths and legends, and a lot of great audience participation in that. And another, of course, was celebrating another 20 years of Evangelion. A lot of anniversaries this year, which was a lot of fun. And even Drac2326, who absolutely hates Evangelion. Okay, he doesn't really hate it. I guess he has kind of a love-hate thing with it. But even Drac participated on that panel. These panels were all organized and, I guess, chaired by Aldo Gomez of Geek News Reviews and Opinions. You've probably seen him if you've seen our show. And we had fun. We had a lot of great audience participation. Unfortunately, I binged-watched the original series of Evangelion and got to see the director cut episodes for the first time ever. Yeah, unfortunately, I didn't get. Somehow, I still didn't get to participate. Somehow, I still was the quiet one. No, I participated, but this is what happens. I just ramble in these vlogs. This is why I gotta stop doing them. But I did participate, but there were a couple questions where I really couldn't answer, like, how has Evangelion affected the mecha genre going forward? And of course, I know it has, but I don't watch a lot of mech shows, and I haven't watched a lot before or since Evangelion to really give a proper opinion. I can maybe give some general examples of how it might affect anime going forward, but nobody ever wanted to give the mic to me. I'm just kidding again. I had fun. I had a tremendous great time doing these panels. They were so, and I hope next year I can organize a panel of my own, get a couple panelists that I like to, maybe some of my same crew, maybe some other people I like, and do my own panel. I just gotta think of a topic first. It's always something I wanted to do is host my own panel, but I'm just always like, what on earth would I talk about? But of course, I went to a couple panels. Now, there weren't a lot of offerings for panels this year, felt like. At least nothing that really grabbed my interest, or sometimes they even conflicted with other events I was at, unfortunately. One was a Legend of Zelda panel, even though I'm such a newbie to the Legend of Zelda franchise, but I'm enjoying what I've gotten out of it so far. But the Zelda panel was very nice. It was hosted by Aaron Yeager, an author. He's an author of some kind. No, he really is. He's an author. I've never really read any of his work, but I've seen him a couple times. I know he was at Banzai last year. He was at Salt Lake Comic Con last year. He was probably there this year too. I'm guessing he's a local. I'm guessing he's local based. I don't know actually, but I know he's a published author. Very nice panel because he really got a lot of us participating. I wanted to at least answer the first question, which is, you know, your experience with the franchise, but he moved on by that point. And I feel bad because my good friend who was sitting right next to me even put herself out there and said something. And I'm like, okay, well, she did. I should do it too. And I didn't. I'm a coward. I'm Shinji. Of course, another event I went to was the AMV contest. I go to those every year. I've pretty much gone to an AMV contest every year since starting to go to conventions. Maybe not the first year, because I don't even know if we did one the first year. Maybe not the second year either, but at least by 2007 or so, I started always going to the AMV contest. I love them, because they're always a way to see some new... In a way, it kind of turns me onto some new anime, and it's just always fun to watch a lot of creative editors. But it also reminds me of why I'll never make AMVs again, because I can never do the things they do. There are some really, really impressive AMVs out there that many people I know no doubt spend hours and hours and hours and pour their hearts and souls into, and they get some truly amazing results. And there's some really creative ones too. And like I said, it turns me on to some interesting anime that I'd never really either paid much attention to before and want to check out now. One of which is Code Geass, which even I didn't see any Code Geass this year, but I saw some last year and I kind of want to check that out now. Although I think it's out of print and probably expensive, but maybe I can scoop up a copy real quick. There's another mech show, I'm not sure what the title is. I'm guessing it might be Aldena Zero. I'm guessing, I don't know. And hopefully when the contest people post this stuff on Facebook, at Anime Banzai's Facebook page, I'll be able to find out. But it was unfortunately only in the honorable mentions category, so I have no clue. Even though I have a giant list here of all the AMVs that they played. It was only in the honorable mentions, which I gotta say, some of the honorable mentions I think deserve to be in the final running a bit more than the final runnings. And of course I hit the dealer's room. I always gotta go shopping. There's always stuff to buy. I was a bit disappointed though with the dealer's room this year because everything felt a lot more expensive compared to previous years. Especially the DVDs. Unfortunately, when it came to DVDs, there was only one, and same with manga too, but I don't really read manga, but when it came to the DVD merchants, there was only really one merchant there, and it was this tiny little cubicle, basically, you know, shelves stacked from ceiling to floor, not quite that big, but you get what I'm saying. But stacked from yay high to the floor here of DVDs, and everything was so expensive. And many stuff that I wanted to get, I'm just like, you know what? I'm sure I can get this cheaper elsewhere. But even plushies were really kind of over the top price. I mean, it could be like a tiny little plush might cost like $25 or something. And I'm like, what justifies this pricing? I get it, sometimes the merchants are, their hands are tied by whomever they buy their merchandise from, by licensing and whatnot, but you would think at a con, maybe you'd be able to score some better deals. But so much was just expensive. I still bought a lot of shit anyway. For one, I bought a whole lot of ramen, which is that awesome drink that I've shown off a few times before, I think, on this channel. So yeah, I bought a whole lot of ramen. Which, I love this stuff, it's delicious for one. It's a weird concoction of a bottle, and I'm sure I've shown it off before, but you unscrew the cap and you kind of just push it in to release it. It's not like your average bottle. Even though a lot of the DVDs I felt were a little overpriced and kind of expensive, there was still some stuff I bought. Still not nearly as much as I expected, but I still bought stuff. For one, I got You're Under Arrest, Full Throttle. Which, I believe is the second or the third season. Oh shit, is this only one half of the series? Fuck that shit, damn it. No, I mean, You're Under Arrest. It's a wonderful show. I had the original series many years ago, but I had to hawk off my set for some quick needed cash, unfortunately, and now it's out of print. I can't find it anywhere. It's so very sad. I'm just disappointed that I did that. I'm kicking myself endlessly, because it's such a fun show. It's about women cops and just their day-to-day lives of being cops, and it's so much fun, and it's a great show. I'm glad I was able to at least find something out of it. Of course, The Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya. Now, really, all I needed was season 2, but Funimation decided to be nice and convenient for everybody else except me and put both seasons together. Normally, this is something you'd praise, but I gotta say, like, damn it, I only needed the second season. Even though I'm really not looking totally forward to it. I never did see the second season. I always heard because of that stupid Groundhog Day plot where they're stuck in a time loop that I just avoided it for a long time. And it wasn't until recently I decided, you know what, I want to finally see the second season. Because I know that's not the whole plot. I know that's only like the first 8 episodes of a 26 episode series. And so I just want to see where the second season goes and see if it's any good or bad and just dragged down by the Endless Eight, or if it's just bad altogether. In fact, I almost paid upwards of $50 to $60 for just the second season on eBay. And thank God Funimation came like right in time to say, hey, we licensed the series. And there, that saved me a ton of money in the end of the day. And of course, the big purchase. It's so big, it's massive. I finally got Cowboy Bebop. Yes, dun dun dun, the hipster show in mainstream. Make all your jokes. Finally time for me to sit down and see what all the fuss is about. Is this truly the world's greatest anime series of all time, or am I gonna just take a massive dump all over it? I don't know yet. I'll have to sit down, I'll have to watch it, but high time I finally see what the fuss is about. I did not see a Blu-ray of it. I know it's on Blu-ray, but didn't see it on Blu-ray, and figured it's there, let's just get it. Now, I also hit up the Artist Alley, which is not usually a place I find myself going very often. Mostly because, I don't know, it's just, it's art. I'm not a huge still pictures kind of guy. I can appreciate artists and I appreciate the work and time they put into it, but didn't really expect to buy anything, just expected to look and admire the art, all the excellent work, but I ended up finding a lot of these. Not just these two, these are chibi acrylic badges. Aren't they just adorable? Oh my god, and I hope the artists do not mind me showing these off on camera, but hopefully they'll forgive me because I'm gonna talk to you about their Kickstarter. This is not an official endorsement or paid endorsement by them to me or anything like that. I just like the idea and I like the concept and I hope you people will too. But look at, and I even got, look at these, oh my god, they're so cute! Shaoran, Sakura, and I got, ah, here he is. And Giro! Giro! So these are, I love these things, they're so cute, and I thought, I was just like, you know what, I can't resist, and I wish I'd gone in there day one and I could have walked around draped like this. Oh, look, I also got this little nice Homer keychain. Got a little soul gem. So cute. They had Kyoka there too. I didn't see a Monica one though. But I only wanted Homura. But yes, these are cute, adorable chibi badges. Look at them. They're just darling. Now, if you want some of your own, don't worry, because they are running a Kickstarter for this. You can see all the details. And you can see all the details on their Kickstarter page, and I'm gonna link it here in the description. I hope this, but it seems like such a fun little idea for art and out there. Maybe you can contribute a little bit and get some of your own, because they're really adorable and I love the idea. So, alright guys, that really is going to do it for the convention vlog. Thanks for sitting through my ramblings. I know I go on and on and on, but I had fun, I had a great time, and got some good stuff, even though a lot of the stuff was a bit expensive, but still got some good stuff anyway. And looking forward to next year.